Come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us adore him. Christ the Lord.
Hey everyone, welcome back to my 6th Vlogmas video. Today it is Saturday the 18th of December and I'm going to have a very nice festive day. I'm going to be celebrating my birthday tonight on YouTube on like a live show with some friends. And I just thought I'm going to make it into a cozy festive Saturday. I just got ready, I've got on this really cute new top and I'm pairing it up with some beautiful pieces of jewelry by Ana Luisa. I'm so excited to be partnering up with Ana Luisa jewelry for this video. They are honestly without a doubt my favorite jewelry brand ever. The reason I love them so much is that they're 100% water and carbon neutral, so they're really green and I'm just beyond obsessed with all of their like designs. Like basically my entire look is jewelry from Ana Luisa. I will give you a little close-up of some of the pieces that I'm wearing today. First of all, this really cool new ring. I finally got myself a thumb ring. It's so cool. And then a little pinky ring as well. This one is really cool because it's like, look. It's like a little chain that you can just put around your finger. And then this necklace, which I'm obsessed with. This is a zodiac sign necklace. So I am a Sagittarius. So of course I picked a Sagittarius, like a, you know, with a bow and arrow. It always reminds me a bit of Katniss. And I think it just looks so beautiful. And I think right now my most favorite pieces are these earrings. They are screaming like vintage retro vibes with the colors and the little swirls. And they're really cute and tiny. They scream my name because I love these colors very much. So I am very happy with these beautiful earrings. If you're thinking, oh my goodness, these pieces are beautiful, I want to check out Ana Luisa, definitely check out their website right now because they're running the biggest sale of the year. Some items are 10% off, whereas some are even 60% off. So get yourself a very last minute Christmas present or just for the new year if you want to, you know, spice up your look a little bit. Get yourself a beautiful necklace or a pair of earrings or rings to get your ring party started. These are also rings from Ana Luisa. Can you tell? I'm very excited about this brand. And also if you want to know more about them being carbon and water neutral and just want to read a bit more about, you know, what they stand for and their values, there is a whole page on their website dedicated to this, which I think is so very important to, you know, support companies that really take the earth into account when creating their products. And lastly, their products range from $39 up and their quality is absolutely brilliant. I've had some pieces for years already and they still look exactly the same as when I got them. Even with like washing my hands when I have these rings on, it is amazing. So I am very excited that this part of the video was in collaboration with Ana Luisa. Thank you again so much. So let's continue with my cozy festive Saturday. Okay, it's like 9:30 in the morning right now. I love the fact that I'm already dressed. I had breakfast. I made some crumpets, as you can see. I got them last week at one of these like British slash American shops here in Rotterdam where you can get all of these foreign foods. And I was craving just some British food. So I got myself some crumpets. I just made it this morning. It's just, it's like comfort breakfast. Love it. But right now I'm just going to be doing some reading because I want to get cozy today and I want to do some reading because I haven't been reading that much lately. I'm not in the best reading mood, unfortunately, but I'm really trying to finish some books before the start of the new year. So the book that I'm currently reading is If We Were Villains by M.L. Rio, which is a really cool dark academia that takes place on this conservatory where someone is dead. And who is a murderer? What happened? So we follow this like group of friends who are all studying at this conservatory and they're all doing these Shakespeare plays. I am over halfway through. I'm a bit further in, I believe, because I listened to some of the audiobook yesterday when I was in bed and I didn't feel like reading it physically. But right now I'm just going to probably be listening to the audiobook and then reading along physically because I really always, like, I feel like that helps me a lot when I'm not in the best reading mood to just listen to a book and then read along with the book. So I'm going to be doing that for a while and let's see how far I can get. I'm loving this one so far, by the way. It is very just dark and mysterious, and the characters are definitely what I'm loving the most. The characters are so well written, and I really feel like I'm getting to know these characters and, you know, their struggles and just their lives. It's really cool. So let's do some reading whilst drinking a cup of tea. So I'm gonna make a cup of tea first. I read like 30 pages. I'm going to be reading a bit more when I get back because I'm going on a little walk now. I have to get myself some new tights because all the, like, they always just break after one or two times of wearing them. But I like wearing tights in winter. Or like, it's not winter, it's autumn, but it feels like winter sometimes. So I need to get myself some new tights. And I thought I would do it early in the morning because it's probably going to be very busy this afternoon because there's a big chance a lockdown is coming again, so all the shops will be closing. Which is such a shame because I'm selling my products into shops, and especially now in December time, it's going really well. And if they close in December and January and maybe February, I'm going to lose some income, which sucks. But oh well, there's nothing I can do about it except go on a walk to clear my mind. Okay, got lots of tights. By the way, I'm still drinking this tea that I made like an hour early. That's cold right now, but it's not even cold. Let me know if I'm the only one who just continues drinking that tea even after it's cooled off a lot. It's like icy, but I got lots of tights. So I'm pretty sure this should last me like 2 weeks. Also got some rubber bands because it's always easy if I want to like close up a packet of crisps or whatever. I also needed these kind of rings that you can use for cooking because for Christmas, on like Christmas Eve, I'm hanging out with some of my friends. We're doing like a small Christmas Eve dinner party and I'm going to be making a lovely like salad thingy that needs to be very pretty and round. So I got these rings that I can use. And lastly, this is a very Dutch thing. I don't know if it, well, I just know everyone in the Netherlands kind of gets these often. It's one of these scratchy advent calendars. By the way, if you're under 18, don't buy this, obviously. But I always get one every year. So basically you have to scratch off one box every day in December and see if you want some money. But it's already the 18th. I'm just gonna scratch off everything. That's what everyone does, by the way. When I still worked in the supermarket, you could already sell these when it was like October, something like that. And sometimes people just came at the end of October with their scratch card for December and they already scratched open every box. So I'm going to be scratching open all of these to see if I want some money. And talking about advent calendars, I haven't even opened mine for today. So let's open my chocolate one first, the 18th of December. I can't get over the fact that it's already the 18th of December. This is white chocolate. Nice. Let's see what it says on the 18th. Tiny, tiny, tiny. It's definitely a very tiny one. And then my rituals one, the beauty one. This is nice, a hair mask. Repair your hair while you daydream of Christmas miracles with our keratin recovery hair mask. I think this is one that you're supposed to put in your hair and then sleep with it. Oh no, leave in for 5 minutes, then rinse thoroughly. Okay. Right now I'm going to scratch open every single one of these boxes. Ooh! I've already won 10 euros! Yes! Ooh! Oh my god, I think I won another 10 euros! Nice! Well, that is a success. Oh my god, there's this disgusting fluff everywhere. I'm gonna vacuum. Yay! I won 10 euros, or like 20 euros in total, so 10 euros. I can buy a new book from that. yeah, again, don't do this often. Just do this for fun once a year during Christmas time. I also still need to wrap a couple of gifts, a birthday gift. I'm using just different paper and a Christmas gift. This is like all my wrapping stuff, fun ribbons and everything. Oh, so let's wrap a couple of presents. Of course, I'm not going to show you the actual presents, but just the wrapping.
On this cold December day, we are on our merry way, riding along, just singing a song, barreling through the snow. Bells are jingling, snowflakes tingling, Rudolph knows where to go. On this cold December day, I am piloting my sleigh. The work to be done on my Christmas run is a most tired chore. No girl or boy without a toy, so giddy up, Rudolph, my dear. Eight pair of antlers onwards ever go. Dasher and Prancer moving through the snow.
Finished wrapping the gifts. I'm still waiting for one gift to arrive, a Christmas gift. But yeah, I like wrapping presents so much. I'm gonna get myself a little quality street chocolate because I wanna get into the festive mood a bit more. When I opened it up, it looked like this and I thought, oh, there's no, you know, what are all the chocolates like? So I looked on the internet because I couldn't remember all of them. So I literally went to Google to find quality street chocolate. Turns out this was in the bottom of the chocolate. I couldn't find it, but here are all. The chocolate's on there. I'm gonna go for a caramel swirl because I haven't... Oh wait, maybe this one because I haven't had this caramel one. A toffee penny. I haven't had this one. This is just straight up toffee, like sugar. This is gonna take a while. Okay, it is 11 past 2 and I only have just over 100 pages left of the book. So I think I'm just going to try to finish it today because my live show won't start until like 7:30 p.m. and I have no other plans today. So I'm going to, again, just listen to the audiobook and read along, and I just, you know, I'm gonna try to finish it right now because I've been reading this one for weeks now. And I think that if I've like actually finish a book again, I will get back into the reading mood a bit. And we're back in lockdown. Why? Literally everything is closed again, just the supermarkets and like the drugstores are open. I've got like 70 pages left on my book, by the way, and I'm going to make a cocktail because On Christmas Eve, I'm meeting up with a few friends and I said I would make the like welcome cocktail, but I need to try it out first to see if it's actually good. So that's what we're gonna do. It's like a pomegranate and gin and some sugar, and like to top it off with some rosemary decorations and pomegranate seeds. However, I don't have those yet because I just want to see if the actual gin and pomegranate and sugar and a little bit of tonic, I believe, tastes good. So let's try it out. Gin, pomegranate, is that the right word? Pomegranate? Now I'm starting to doubt myself. Yes, pomegranate. Lemon juice. I can't be bothered to squeeze out a lemon. Some tonic to top it off. I have got some tonic in the fridge as well. 2 teaspoons of sugar, and then some rosemary and pomegranate seeds for decoration. I've got like a cocktail shaker, but I don't really know how much this is. Let's see. Okay, so this is 50 mils. And then this is probably half of that. I've also got a cocktail shaker. My kitchen is a mess, by the way. Is it still recording? Yes. Okay, let's see. First, the gin. It's very dark. Ah, and at last I see the light. Then half of the pomegranate. And then like a little bit. It's like 15 mils, so it's like a little less than half. Something like this. And then they set to just shake it. I'm gonna do it in just this glass with some ice cubes. Pour it in. And they said to top it off with some tonic, but I don't know how much. So I'll just do a little bit because I think there's quite a lot of gin in here. Like this. Okay, taste test. Ooh. I quite like, oh no, I forgot the sugar. I was like, it's quite bitter, but I forgot the sugar. I'm just gonna put in a teaspoon of sugar and see if I can mix it up. They said to put 2 teaspoons of sugar. That's quite a lot. I'll just do 1. I don't know if this is going to dissolve. How difficult is it to look up 4 ingredients and put 4 ingredients in there? And I still managed to forget 1. Okay. Yes. Ooh, I like this. I'm very happy. I'm going to be making this one for Christmas Eve dinner. It is so tasty. Mmm. Okay, I'm going to just try to finish the entire book right now. I have this much left, so not a lot. And I will see you when I've hopefully finished it. I ordered pizza because I'm sad because of lockdown. And now I'm going to watch The Office. I have not finished the book yet. I have like, what is it, 40 pages left. So I don't know if I'll be able to finish it today because I have my live show in a bit, but right now I'm going to continue watching The Office. It is many hours later. I'm tired. My hair is like completely flat. I don't know what happened. But I had so much fun in my birthday live show. I hang out with so many of my BookTube friends. I will link all of their channels down below. They're all the best. You have to check them out. And it was just so much fun. Oh my God, I love chatting to just my online friends. How brilliant is it that because of BookTube, I have made so many amazing friends. So thank you so much if any of you guys watched or joined the live show. Yay. But now I'm very tired and I still haven't read or like finished If We Were Villains. However, I have like, what is it, 30 or 40 pages left. So I will definitely finish it tomorrow. So I will end the vlog tomorrow so I can, you know, tell you about my final thoughts. I'm gonna go to bed now. I'm gonna make this quick because my washing machine is on and I'm pretty sure that you can hear it. But it is Sunday morning, it is 11 a.m. and I just finished If We Were Villains. I thought it was so good. I'm gonna give it, I think, 4, maybe 4.5 out of 5 stars, but I will still think about it a little bit. But yes, I'm very happy I finally read this book and it is definitely worth the hype. So this was a successful reading weekend. I feel like I'm getting back into the reading mood, so I'm very happy about that. But right now I'm going to get ready because some of my friends are coming over tonight for my birthday, but I'm going to be making a separate Vlogmas video for just like celebrating my birthday and opening some presents. So I'll see you in the next one. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos. And if you want to comment something, and if you've reached the end of this video and you want to comment something but you don't know what to comment, comment a little gift emoji, like a present, because the jewelry from Ana Luisa is just perfect for gifting as like a holiday gift or a birthday gift. Again, don't forget to check out the link in my description to take a look at all of the items that are on sale. And if you want to follow me on my social media, I always link everything down below in the description as well. Again, thanks so much for watching. I hope you're having a beautiful day and I will see you in